I'm in stealth mode. I've got a Marvel Legends unboxing, but it's about being in stealth mode because it is stealth armor Iron Man. Do you know what? I don't need to talk quiet. Stealth armor Iron Man, brand new Marvel Legends, well, brand new release here in the UK. We're having a bit of trouble at the minute getting our orders in. Apparently there's some sort of pandemic on and it's delaying a few shipments coming in. Do you know what? It's fine. It's a first world problem. There's a lot worse things going on out there. But we are getting in dribs and drabs this Iron Man wave, which has got the Ursa Major Builder figure. I've got the cool Iron Man. I've also got the cool Guardsman as well. But this wave in the UK delays from Hasbro. We're waiting for Modular Iron Man. We're waiting for Darkstar. We're waiting for Ironheart. We're waiting for the Translucent Iron Man and Ultron. Now, some suppliers have got them in already. Hasbro having trouble. Gaming Geeks, shout out to Gaming Geeks. Go and look at their website. GamingGeeks.co.uk. Got me these sweet figures. So we're going to have a look at these today. Stealth Armor Iron Man from a particular favourite era of the Iron Man comics for me, which is back around about that mid-200 run, or early 200s run, around about the time of the classic Armor Wars, which we've already covered on this show, on another episode, which you can go and find on our channel right now. The stealth armour came about initially when Tony went off to Russia to confront Crimson Dynamo and Titanium Man because they had stolen parts of his armour technology that had been stolen by Spymaster and sold to Justin Hammer. So off he went in this super awesome, cool stealth armor, which also had a reflective camouflage tech on it, which turned him invisible in the snow. Brilliant, brilliant series. Brilliant, brilliant armor. Crops up in another couple of series and story arcs over the years, and it's fantastic. So, as we always do, let's have a look at the box first of all. So there is the box. Really cool artwork on the side. And there we go. It's the Ursa Major Builder figure, which is just the bear, so I'm probably not that interested in that. Would have been nice if maybe had a little Russian hat or maybe a little Russian hammer and sickle armband on the side there, but hasn't got it, so not overly keen on that. It is a really cool one with some really cool figures in here, though. So I'm probably gonna have to get most of the wave anyway, so I probably will end up with a builder figure. But straight up glorious look at that armor. Bit more detail here. Now this is a repaint. We have had the 80th anniversary Iron Man, which you can see here on the shelf, and here collectible in the box unopened. And you then have this year already, 2021, the AI Iron Man, which is here, which is just fantastic, possibly my figure of the year so far. And now we've got the stealth armor version. So, like we always do, let's get this bad boy out of the box. Okay, first things first, inside the box artwork. I love that. That's awesome. That is very similar to, that's very much looking like the modular Iron Man armor that we've got coming as part of this wave. That is excellent. What we'll do, I'll quickly refer you to the inside of the Guardsman's box as well, which is here, which is just sort of circuitry. You can see that there. I thought maybe it might build something, but it doesn't. Never mind, but I like that. Crash, crash. Okay, so Iron Man, stealth Iron Man, accessories. Ursa Major leg. That is pretty cool, to be honest. It's quite good. We have hands. Shooting hands, there we go, one of each to go with that. Shooting lasers, nice red this time, very different, can mix it up a lot. Got a lot of yellow and a lot of orange on the other armors that you've got across the back here as well, so I can do a bit of mix and match with those. So that's pretty cool. We've got some different shape ones or some different armors, so that's quite smart. And this is awesome. This is wicked. Look at that, Tony Stark head. That's excellent. That will clearly end up being interchangeable with all my other armors over here for some pretty sweet Hall of Armor shots. And now here is the figure, Oh yeah. Now in hand, this is brilliant. I love it. There is some different shades to the blue. You can see got a little bit darker on the chest here against the arms there. Same with the boots, dark on the boots, and you've got more of the sheen on the legs. This is really cool. The eyes, you've got the red eyes, see that in there, and the red mouth like that, which is really cool. It goes really well with the repulsor beam colouring in the middle. So that's great. Really, really love that look to it. Good movement to it. Let's have a look. So a bit stiff to get them going. There we go. So we've got good ab crunch on him. Knee bends, double knees, double elbows, so we can get them in opposing fists. Would have maybe liked some flight hands with him to do some just flying up straight poses, but that's fine, that's cool, I can live with that. I've probably got some normal blue hands, plain blue hands from about a million other figures that I can put them on. But that's really cool, really like that. Good shape. Let's say straight out repaint the other one, so you know what you're getting. But these are so cool figures. I don't think you can have enough Iron Man figures. These comic book versions are my absolute favorite, so they are really, really super cool. So I really do like this one. Looks really good, really great detail on it. I very much like the comic book exactly, so this would be a great addition to go with these Iron Dudes up here. Quick look while we're here, because why not, a little bonus one as well. Let's have a look at the Guardsman figure. So for the Guardsman, we've got Ursa Major's left arm, hand, claw there on that one. Quite cool. And then we've got, with the Guardsman, we have shooting hands. And I've got a fist there, because I've got one shooting hand on already. And then we have the pretty sweet gun that comes with the Guardsman as well, which is weird because they have repulsor technology as well, because it was also stolen from Tony Stark in the Armor Wars series there. And there is a Guardsman. I love this figure so much. I just think this is fantastic. I've had this one a few weeks. Again, Gaming Geeks. Hello, Gaming Geeks. I've been playing with this for ages. So I've already swapped over, put one of the gun hands in already, as you can see there, which doesn't have a trigger finger, which is a bit of a shame. It's become quite used to having some pretty sweet trigger finger figures over the last few years. We don't have that with the Guardsman. So you've got to really sort of get the pose right if you're doing some action pose shots, get it sort of just at the right angle so it looks quite cool, which I've done on a few of these. But the fantastic look of the Guardsman, it's so comic book accurate. You've got the different, throw it away, you've got the different shades of the green on the armor, the face very classic, good. The eyes got that real sort of just enough sinister. And the Guardsman guard the vault, whereas in the comic books was the original superhero lockup jail before you had the raft, which is something you've seen in the MCU lately as well. So they were the original Guardsman, funny enough, because they're called Guardsman for that. And it really, really cool. So some really good, very comic accurate designs and styles to it. The green is spot on. So the eyes have got just a touch of sinister in them to look a menacing figure. So if it is imposing against supervillains, it does a job. And Iron Man has to go up against them in the Silver Centurion arm when he comes up against the Captain, which is Steve Rogers, at the same time as part of that storyline as well. So I'm going to have a lot of fun posing up and fighting up these bad boys against each other. Let's have another quick look at the detail. So here's the stealth armor Iron Man in the detail there. And another look at the Guardsman. These are two great figures. Very excited to get these. Really looking forward to getting the rest of the waves. I'm particularly excited about getting the Ultron. It's a real comic book accurate Ultron. And the modular Iron Man, which I'm rereading that original run, which is sort of from like 300s onwards, sort of 280 onwards with the modular Iron Man armor, which is really, really great, just after the introduction of War Machine at that stage. So that's a really great blast from the past for me. These are great figures. I'm really looking forward to posing with all these and sticking them with my Hall of Armors. Now what I've got to do is build a Hall of Armors. Sounds easy. So I'm going to go and do that now. And while I'm doing that, give this a little thumbs up at the bottom and give it a little subscribe if you're not already. And do go and have a look at whatever videos we've got on the channel. That would be great. You can have a look at the Armor Wars series, a little bit of review for you there if you've not read that. That's it. Thanks. See you next time. And remember, stealth mode.